All right, it's just now 2:30, so we'll go ahead and get started here. So I'd like to welcome everyone to the IAC Acoustics Acutone 2 Medical and Life Sciences webinar. My name is Jeremy Vizza, and I am the Architectural Sales Manager here at IAC Acoustics. And today we're going to discuss the Acutone 2 series medical enclosures. Throughout the presentation, should you come across any questions, feel free to type them into the GoToWebinar application. And at the end of this, I will look into the chat box there and answer whatever may be in there. So before I deep dive into the product, I do want to talk a little bit about, you know, who is IAC Acoustics, who's the Catalyst Acoustics Group, and things like that. So IAC Acoustics is part of a parent group that's called the Catalyst Acoustics Group. Again, they're the parent company, but they hold an elite group of noise control companies. These companies offer a broad portfolio, such as acoustic, seismic, vibration, noise control, things like that. You may have noticed that I've used the terms noise control and sound control already, both of them. I do want to point out that there is a difference there, and I purposely use both of them. So, you know, the main thing that IAC does, the majority of our work is controlling noise, which is exactly what the medical product is intended to do. However, we do have product lines that are more about tuning the acoustics of a room rather than just reducing the noise. So the way I like to look at it is this. Noise is your neighbor mowing their grass. Sound is you mowing your grass. And music is your neighbor mowing your grass. Point is, it's the same source. It's really the same thing that you're hearing. But I like to look at noise more as an annoyance. It's a disturbance. Where sound doesn't have to be, right? So think of like a studio. If we're doing music studios, we're not there just to get rid of the sound. We're there to tune it, right? To make the acoustics of that room as good as they can be for recording or whatever it may be. For a medical booth, the whole point is to get rid of as much noise as possible. So again, it's all about the you know, the application. It's completely subjective. So I do like to delineate the two, noise and sound. So the medical and life sciences team is consisted of, there's three of us here. We have Thomas Hines. He's the director of IAC. He's been with the company for about 20 years now and just has exceptional product knowledge. So he was actually an installer for IAC for, I would say, I think it was about 10 years of his career. He's installed all of the product that IAC manufactures. He was the head installer on some of the largest projects IAC's ever done. And he just, you know, he brings a massive wealth of knowledge to the table, you know, and it's just a great thing for us here. We got Rick Eatsy, the architectural sales estimator. He actually spent a good 20 years of his career working in the manufacturing facility. And so he brings a unique aspect to our sales team because a lot of the salespeople that I run into, at least, they don't have that kind of knowledge of how the product is actually manufactured. You know, what really goes into it. So it's great to have him on the team because he can really deep dive into, you know, the ins and outs of how our doors or our panels or whatever it may be, however that stuff is built. So it's great to have him here on the team. Then there's me, Jeremy Vizza. I went to school for acoustics. I got my bachelor's of science degree in acoustics from Columbia College in Chicago. And I have been with IAC for about 4 years now. So again, before we go into the product, let's talk a little bit about, you know, why IAC over the competition. I could talk about this for days on end, but I had to limit it down to a few reasons here. The first that I will focus on is the in-house powder coating line. Now, having this in-house gives us a huge advantage because it eliminates the need to outsource. Now, when you outsource the powder coat, your lead time can lengthen substantially. You got to think about it like this, you know, let's say I build a door and I have to get it powder coated. Well, I got to crate up that door, ship it out to the powder coater, which has lead time. Then once it arrives there, they got to uncrate it and then it gets in line, right? That also has lead time. Let's say that the powder coater just started a project with 10,000 mufflers. Then I would give them my one door. It's not likely that they'll stop the job of 10,000 mufflers, change the powder out just to run my one door through the line. It's just not going to happen. there's not really a lot of options to expedite with the powder coaters. So that part can give you a heck of a lot of lead time there. But then once they do powder it, they got to crate it back up, send it back to our factory. Again, lead time. And then the worst part is, what if there's imperfections? What if we get it back and the quality control is going through it and they come across a bubble or a scratch or just a bad paint job, whatever it may be? Well, we got to send it back to them. They got to sand it down, run it back through the line. Again, all of which has lead time. The beauty of having it here in our manufacturing facility, if there's any imperfections that are found, well, we sand it down right then and there, and we hang it back on the line, run it back through. So from the time that an imperfection is found to the time that it's fixed, it could be an hour or two instead of a week. So that really helps us keep our lead time to the standard of 8 weeks that we have. And again, just a massive advantage that we do have. Another reason is IAC guarantees the performance of all of the products with laboratory test data. We guarantee it. If there's ever, for whatever reason, a piece of our material in field and it's just not working, we're going to come out there, we're going to take a look at it, we're going to figure out why it's not working. 99.9% of the time, it's not because the product doesn't work. Usually it's an installation issue. And for that weird, odd time that it might be the IAC product, we're just going to replace it. The product works and we guarantee it. So when we do come across situations where something's not performing, we jump all over it because it just doesn't make a lot of sense. We want to figure out what's going on there. So we actually do have test reports for everything that we publish, all the data that we publish. There are test reports that were done in an accredited laboratory with a third party consultant present. And we do have those available upon request. I don't provide them just on the website or anything like that. But if you do want to take a look at those numbers in some detail, I'm happy to send them over. IAC Acoustics also has UL listings for electrical and fire. Our doors can have a UL fire rating of up to 90 minutes with a wood veneer and a UL fire rating of up to 180 minutes without the wood veneer. And take a look at this picture on the left there. That's a good example of the wood veneer doors the wood veneer that we could put on the doors. So these are steel doors, obviously. But that doesn't always work in an architectural application. They want it to look nice, right? They don't want just the bare steel in there. So the wood veneer is a great option there. Just kind of makes it more aesthetically pleasing while still performing acoustically. So all of IAC's electrical components are UL listed, as well as their assemblies. If you take a look at this picture on the top middle, you'll see there's that UL tag, the white tag there. Every single electrical panel is going to have its own individual tag. And so that's just, it's big there. Having the UL labels and all that, it's a massive selling point that we like to focus on there. Because a lot of the times, public projects and things like that, UL isn't an option there. It's a must, right? You have to have it. So we do like to point that out. So IAC hangs and swings every single door that comes through our shop. The reason we do that is to ensure proper fit, finish, and function in the field. Part of our QC process is to take pictures of every door in the open and the closed position while it's hanging in the rack in our shop. That's exactly what that picture is showing you with the door that's hanging in the rack in a closed position. So what we do is we get all these pictures and we put them into a folder that we call a secondary submittal. Let's say you have a double leaf door with a coordinator on there, and what that does is it closes the doors in a proper sequence. We'll actually take video footage of that coordinator operating as it's supposed to. And we have the secondary submittal folder on our drives. We don't send it out automatically, but it is there. It's there for a couple of reasons. It's there to protect, one, IAC, and two, the customer. If you buy and resell some product, a door, for example, and the end user is saying that something's not working, maybe for whatever reason, maybe got bumped into in the field or something happened to the hardware, let's say, and it's just not working. And somebody might be trying to say that it's our fault or it's their fault, or just trying to, whatever it may be. We always like to provide the secondary submittal saying, okay, we have pictures of this thing working, right? We have pictures of how it looked and this and that. So it's really there to protect you, the customer, and us, and just kind of make everyone's life easier And it's not about dodging problems or anything like that. It's just about, hey, let's not point fingers here. Let's talk through what's going on, what happened, and we'll get through it. So again, that's called the secondary submittal, and it's so far it's been a great addition to what we do. All right, enough about all that though. Let's talk about the product that you were all here to hear about today. So this is the Accutone 2 series. It's what houses all of the medical and life sciences product. Our slogan here you can see at the bottom is any size, any shape, and any color. So there's five main categories that I'm gonna focus on here. We have the mini booths, the classic audiometric booths, the audiometric suites, the multi-person booths, and then enhancement packages. So these are the 252 and 254 mini booths. The difference between the two is the size and therefore the weight, but they can both fit through a standard 3070 door. The mini booths have a design that is engineered to allow flexibility in any environment, and they can actually be quickly transformed to achieve a right or left-hand configuration. Take a look at that picture on the left. You'll notice that there's two doors there. So every one of these booths is going to have two doors on it. And so that's how you're able to achieve the right or left hand. So let's say you want the door on the left to be the operational one, but you don't want to use the door on the right. Well, there's a clasp on the roof of this booth. So whatever door you decide to not use, you just jump up on a ladder or a chair, whatever it may be, and you just lock that clasp in place. And so now that door can open. Take a look at the inside of that right door there. You're going to notice a fabric panel. We also provide one fabric panel with each mini booth. And the point of that is whatever door you decide to not use and you lock, that panel just sits on the inside of that door so that, when a patient walks into that booth, they can hardly even tell that there's a door there if they can at all. The fabric panel just really kind of makes it seem like that it's just a panel. That's just a wall there. It's not really a door. It also adds a little bit of absorption in there. So it's going to give you more of a dead environment on the inside of that booth. So these booths are on casters to allow for ready positioning and mobility. There is the option to switch to vibration isolators if you're in a building where structure-borne noise is a concern. That is a great time to switch over to the isolators. Obviously, by doing that, you're gonna reduce your mobility because it's not on wheels anymore. But again, I've only ever seen that because structure-borne noise was a concern. It's just good to point out that there is an option for that. So we try our best to keep five of each of these mini booths in stock, and we do have the capability to manufacture them quickly. All of that together is why our lead time for the mini booths is only 2 weeks, 2 weeks from the date that I received the order. And if there's some in stock, we can have them ship out within a day or two. These booths do come off of the fabrication line fully assembled and ready for infield placement, so you don't have to worry about installation or anything like that. If you look at the picture on the right, that is what they look like. Obviously, those aren't wrapped up and ready to ship, but that's the stage that they're at, is to get wrapped up and get ready to ship. But the point is they will ship out to you fully assembled and just ready to use. You just got to plug it in, and you're ready to rock and roll. If you want to learn a little bit more about these mini booths, because there's a lot more I can continue to talk about, but I'm going to direct you to the IAC Acoustics YouTube channel. There's actually a Did You Know video is what we call it, but it's a video that goes into a lot more detail about this. So one, if you want to learn about the booths, or number two, if you want to put a face to the voice that you're hearing, it's actually me in that video. But again, go over to the IAC Acoustics YouTube channel. There's a bunch of Did You Know videos there, really just deep diving into most of our product. So the next category that we're going to focus on is the classic audiometric booth series. This includes the 40A single wall, the 800A enhanced single wall, and the 120A double wall models. So the 40A series uses 4-inch thick single wall construction, and we throw a STC51 door on there. All this together is going to give you a performance of NIC 50. There's also the option of adding a 1-inch enhancement package to the interior, which will effectively increase your performance to an NIC 53. And if you take a look at the brochure for this series, you're going to notice something that we call standard sizes. Now, I'm indifferent about the term standard there. As you can see, I put it in quotations. Remember the motto of this whole series, the Acutone 2. Any size, any shape, any color. The main part I want to focus on there is any size. So while we do call them standard sizes, we can build these booths to be any size that they need to be, any size that you need to fit into your space. I like to call them not standard sizes, but starting points. You know, if you're just getting going and you're just thinking about, okay, I'm probably going to need a booth sometime coming up here, view it as a starting point, but feel free to, you know, wander off of those quote unquote standard sizes. One thing I do like to point out to people is the price of these booths does not automatically increase because you're off of a standard. If you increase a dimension, of course, there's more labor there, there's more material. So the price will go up if you grow the booth in size, of course. But it's not going to increase just because you're off of a standard. There's no, you know, non-standard fee or custom fee or whatever it may be. Just like to point that out, because I have seen that people get a little bit concerned because they're like, oh, I'm off of a standard now, so the price is going to double. It's just not the case. Just keep that in mind. Remember, any size, any shape, and any color. So these booths have a standard interior height of 6 foot and 6 inches. The reason for that is that allows them to fit in a host building that has an 8 foot ceiling height. So 6 foot 6 on the inside of the booth will be able to fit into an 8 foot host ceiling height. We do have the option to, or the capabilities, I should say, to increase the height. We actually buy our sheet steel in 12 foot lengths. So we can increase up to 12 feet inside height very, very easily. We can actually go above 12 feet. You know, we can start staggering wall panels and using structural support. For the medical industry, I don't see a lot of booths above 12 feet. To be quite honest, I don't see a lot of medical booths at 12 feet. But it's, you know, every now and again, you do see those odd ones out there. So just keep in mind that it is possible if the need ever arises. So this is the 800A series. This uses a 4-inch thick panel with a 4-inch thick enhancement package. So this will give you a total 8-inch thick wall construction. We also upgrade the door to this booth. This is actually a 3.5-inch thick STC-61 door. And when you put all that together, you're going to get a performance of NIC-60. Now, the 800 series also has a list of standard sizes, but again, starting point. I'm going to keep nailing that point home there because it's time and time again, I run into this probably about, you know, a few times a week where people just get concerned about moving off of the standard. Those are starting points. Feel free to move off the standard as much as you like. So the enhancement package, again, I do have a slide coming up here that will go into a little bit more detail, but just briefly, it consists of metal liner panels, fabric wrap panels, and a chair rail that covers the joint between the two. But again, I will go into some more detail coming up here. So this is the 120A series. This uses 2 4-inch thick panels, and then we use a 4-inch airspace in between those two panels. So your actual wall construction is 12 inches thick. We use 2 STC-51 doors here. All this together is going to give you a performance of NIC-70. So if you look at this picture, or the drawing, I should say, you're going to notice that there's the in-swing door and the out-swing door. There is the option to switch that to a tandem out-swing door. Some people call it the piggyback doors. Really all it is both doors are going to be swinging outwards. So there's a little mechanism that connects the two doors in between. And you pull the outer door, that inner door is going to open with it. Where the current configuration, you got to pull the outer door, then push the inner door. Now, there's also a third option here that I don't see very often, but every now and again I do. But we can actually pull both those doors out and install 1 STC-64 door in there. Now, keep in mind, the STC-64 door is 5 inches thick. It's heavy, but you know, switching from two of these doors and only replacing it with one, it's got to be a thick, heavy door to make the performance stay where it needs to. It is an option. Again, I don't see it very often. I'm not too sure why people would switch if they could just do the double outswing. But you know, to each their own. It is just know that it is an option. Now, this is the performance chart. This shows the noise reduction for the models that I just talked about. You could find this chart on most of the IAC literature, which is posted on our website. Again, we do have test reports for all of our published data, and I can provide those upon request. Just shoot me a text or send me an email, whatever it may be, if you want to discuss these numbers in more detail. I like to put this up here because, you know, me just saying it may not be sufficient. Obviously, there's different learners out there in the world, and sometimes visualizing is a little bit better, a little bit easier for some. So I do like to throw this in there just so you can kind of visualize the difference in performance of the boost that I'm talking about here. All right, so these are the ACT series suites. Each includes a control room and an exam room. It stands for Audiometric Control Test. I call it an exam room. Some people call it a test room, same thing. Now there's five options to choose from here. You got the 40 ACT, the 800 ACT, the 120 ACT, the 140 ACT, and the 160 ACT. So what does that actually mean? So this is the 40 ACT series. It gives you a single wall control room and single wall exam room. Each are gonna have 4-inch thick wall construction. Each will have one STC 51 door, and each is gonna give you a performance of NIC 50. This is literally just two single wall booths put together to create a suite. And obviously they have the windows in between so you can look into one another. There is the option to share that center wall there. If you take a look at the center of this booth or the suite, you're gonna notice there's two middle walls. There's the option to share that. So it would just be one middle wall. A couple of reasons you would do that. One, if you need to reduce the footprint of this booth, let's say you just don't have enough space. Well, if you think about it, we're gonna be removing one 4-inch wall and a 4-inch airspace. So by combining those and sharing that wall, you're actually going to reduce your footprint by 8 inches. Another reason is cost. That will decrease your cost because, again, we're removing an entire wall there. Whether it's 3 panels or 10 panels, it's less material, less labor. So it will decrease your cost a little bit. And the third reason, the one I don't see this very often, but I have seen it once or twice, is people need to reduce their weight. You know, if you're in an older building or just a building that has certain weight restrictions, that is a reason that I've seen people share that wall. Because again, you're removing, you know, let's say 5 panels or whatever it may be, that obviously has weight to it. So those are the three main reasons that I do see people share that wall. It obviously will decrease your room to room performance because instead of having two walls and an airspace, now you only have just one wall. So your performance will decrease a little bit. But again, it all depends on the application and what you're trying to do and what the restrictions are and all that stuff. So again, we could talk through all that with, you know, project specific if you'd like. So this is the 800 ACT series. This has a single wall control room and an enhanced single wall exam room. So your single wall is going to give you an NIC 50. Your enhanced single wall will give you an NIC 60. You can see here that only the exam room has the enhancement package. If you want both rooms to have it, it's very easy to do. It's not listed as a quote unquote standard, but we do it. You can also, again, share that center wall if you'd like. Keep in mind that the exam room does have a higher performing door there. So it's still a single door, just like the control room, but it is, you can tell it's thicker. The control room has a 2.5-inch thick door. The exam room has a 3.5-inch thick door. And again, that's all just to keep the performance of NIC 60 that's required by that exam room there. So this is the 120 ACT series, one of the more common ones that we see. It's a double wall control room and a double wall exam room. Both will give you an NIC of 70. And I pretty much already touched on all the other options here. The next two are the ones that I do like to focus on here. We have the 140 ACT series and the 160 ACT series. Now I'm going to switch back and forth a couple of times. I want you to take a look at the middle, in between these two booths here, the middle. You can see we got three walls on this one, and we got two walls on this one. So this is an integrated single wall control double wall exam, where this one is an independent single wall control double wall exam. The only difference between the two is so to get to the 140 ACT, which is this one, to get that, all we did was take a 160 ACT, which is this one, and we shared one of the walls. You can see we removed one wall and an airspace, and we just butted that control room up to the test room. Literally all we did there. The 140 ACT is by far the most popular. You know, people want the performance, the NIC 70 performance for the exam room, for whatever it is that they're testing. And then they just want, a good enough performance for the control room, whatever it may be. Every now and again, we see the 160 ACT go through. That's usually if people are going to use this for some type of recording, they want just massive performance room to room. So, with three walls and two airspaces between the two rooms, you are going to have a pretty drastic performance increase there. So this is actually the highest ACT series performance room to room. All right, so I already talked a little bit about the height capabilities the IAC has, but just to reiterate, we do buy our stock steel in 12-foot lengths. So we have the capabilities to increase your interior height from the 6'6" standard to 12 feet very, very easily. And then if you need to go above 12 feet, that's also no problem. And again, we do that by staggering wall panels and including structural support. I just like to throw this in here to kind of give a visual aspect of the what I'm saying. So these are the multi-man audiometric booths. They're offered in the 40M single wall series and the 120M double wall series. The standard occupancy range is 1 to 10. However, we have designed rooms to hold up to 14 people. Usually this is more of a we mostly see the, military buying these, and they do it for like MEPS, right? So like military entrance stuff. So if they need to test, 10 troops at once or whatnot, this is a big booth for them. We can design these booths to hold, 20 people if they need it. Never seen that one before. It would be a little interesting, but it is possible. So we actually provide divider curtains for in between each testing station. As you can see, that's what the little squiggly lines are in between those stools. We do have an option to switch the curtains out for fabric wrap panels. A couple of things to note there. I do warn people that the curtains are nice because when the station's not in use, it's got a shower curtain. You can just kind of throw it into the wall, really, and it just glides along its track, and it just kind of collapses onto each other, right? Like accordion style, if you will. Fabric panels aren't going to do that. When a fabric panel is there and the station is not in use, it's just kind of there, right? So it's going to make it a little bit more cramped in there. It will add more absorption. So if you're looking for a more dead environment on the inside for whatever reason, that's a good reason to switch to the fabric panels. But I do like to advise people to stick with the curtains because it just, if you're not testing six people at once, you don't need those curtains to be closed. You don't need the curtains to be kind of pulled out and blocking the stations. It just makes it more of an open space. And these booths are already kind of, they could be a little bit cramped already, especially with the noise reduction that they're giving you. So, making it as comfortable as possible for however many people you have in there is important to us. So I do highly suggest you stick with the divider curtains. Now, each station is going to have a station jack plate that has three quarter inch jacks on it. And then there's going to be a master jack plate that'll have enough quarter inch jacks to accommodate each station. We do have the capabilities to make custom jack plates. We actually do it quite often. All we need to know is what kind of connections you need and how many of each. We can draw up a custom plate for you, get it manufactured rather quickly. And again, that is a very common request that we get. So, all right, the enhancement package. So here you can see the options for the color of panels, carpet, and fabric wrap panels. So there's a lot of options to choose from in terms of customizing the enhancement package here. The picture on the left demonstrates what the interior enhancement package actually looks like. So you have the metal liner panel on the bottom, the fabric wrap panel on the top, and then, like I said, that chair rail covering the joints. Now, also, if you take a look at the joint between the floor and the wall and the ceiling in the wall, you'll notice that there's that black cove molding there. And also, if you take a look at the window, obviously, we have our aluminum extruded frame there. But the other part of it, the black part of that frame, we do all that on purpose. So it all kind of coincides with each other. It all matches and just really gives it an aesthetically pleasing look. And again, the enhancement package also increases your performance. But you'll see this color chart here. You know, it says, you know, if you look at the picture on the right, it's telling you, you know, number one is the exterior, number two is the liner panels, number three is the fabric panels, number four is the floor or the carpet. You don't have to stay in line like number one where it says panel. It's only showing you five colors if you follow the line down. You don't have to stay in line there. You can jump all over the place choosing your colors here. That's just the standards that we have. Again, jump back to our motto here. Any size, any shape, any color. That last part, any color. If you want a special color that we don't have in our standards, no problem. We'll need either an RAL number or a physical sample, and we'll just go match it and make it happen. It does increase the cost a little bit. A lot of the powders that we buy have a minimum purchase quantity. So let's say, you know, we're doing like a 6x6 booth. Maybe we only need, you know, 20 pounds of powder to make it work. Some of these powders have a minimum 50 pound purchase quantity, right? So it will increase the price a little bit. If you want to do a custom color, just know that it is possible. And we do that quite often. There is the option also, so if you're not a big fan of the metal liner panel on the bottom there, there's the option to switch to full length fabric panels, so floor to ceiling. One reason that I see this happen is people want more absorption in that room, so they'll switch to the full length fabric. It obviously just is going to add a little bit more absorption than the metal liner panel there. Another reason is weight. Again, it goes back to the weight. So a metal liner panel obviously weighs more than a fabric panel. So to reduce the weight, you know, if they have host restrictions there, that's a good reason to do it. And a third reason is just the aesthetics of it. Some people just like the look of, you know, the full length panels better than having this joint there, which is just fine. You know, we can do it the way you see in this picture. We can do it a full length fabric panel. We could do full length metal panel. Doesn't matter to us. Point is that we do have the capabilities to customize these things pretty drastically. All right, so I've gone over a majority of the categories that we are going to go over today, but how do you actually go about designing one of these booths? There's a few things you want to take into consideration. The obvious ones are the desired performance and desired booth model. These are two massive decisions to make, and they're really the starting point. So you need to determine, you know, depending on what you're doing, what the application is for, or what the application is, I should say, is NIC 50 going to be good enough? Or do you need something better than that? Do you need an NIC 60 or a 70? You also got to think about, you know, do you need a control and a test room? Do you need a mini booth? Is that going to be sufficient? Do you need a multi-person? Are you going to be testing multiple people at once? Or is just a single classic booth going to be sufficient? So, again, it all depends on the application and like host constraints and things like that. So if you're not sure, give me a shout. That's what I'm here for, is to kind of help guide down the thought process. Stumbling over my words here, but point is, give me a shout if you don't know where to start or having trouble, you know, answering one of these questions. And like I said, that's what I'm here for. So I'd be happy to help out. You also have to consider if there's host facility constraints, which I keep talking about. You know, host room height is a big one. If there's a support column in the way, that's another big one. If there is, it's no problem. We'll just jog around that column. It's very easy for us to do. One aspect that I see that's missed quite frequently is if there are any local, state, or federal requirements. What I mean by this is ADA compliance. That's a big one. That's a huge one because it gets missed a lot, right? And the worst thing that can happen is to install one of these booths for you just to find out that, whoops, somebody forgot that this needs to be ADA compliant, and it's currently not. So that's not a good situation for anybody. We have a lot of options to choose from when it comes to low profile floors. Our step up into the booth is 6 1/8 inch thick. In terms of ADA compliance, you need a pretty big ramp to have that ramp be ADA compliant to go up 6 inches. So, you know, we can do floors that are 1/2 inch thick. We can do floors that are, you know, a couple inches, 3 inches, 4 inches, whatever it may be. We have all of those options, but if you think about it too late in the game, it could be a dangerous thing. I can get very expensive very quickly. Another design consideration to think about is what electrical you're going to need. What comes standard inside of our booths is one duplex outlet, a toggle switch for the lights, and a toggle switch for the fans. But we do have options to add quad receptacles, dimmer switches, empty electrical boxes that you can use for, you know, data drops, phone drops, fire strobes, thermostats, or whatever it may be. I do like to include this specific picture here because obviously, one, that's not a medical booth, that is a studio, but I like to include it because there's a whole heck of a lot of energy being pulled from all that equipment in there. And if you only have that one duplex, it's just not going to work very well. You're going to be blowing that circuit every time you turn something on. You're going to need some crazy amount of extension cords and extra outlets plugged in, and it's just going to be not a good situation. Definitely not up to code if you plug in 30 things there. Point is, you know, you really want to think through what kind of equipment are you going to have on the inside of this, because we can do a lot during the design phase to make sure you have enough electricity and enough outlets and whatever it is that you may need. Standard, we have one dedicated circuit. We ask for one dedicated circuit, but if you're going to be pulling a whole bunch of juice, we can customize it so that it will require two dedicated circuits. You know, there's a lot we can do to just kind of beef it up for you to make sure that it's going to be able to, you know, deliver the performance electrically that you need. So that is actually all I have for you today. So again, if there's any questions, please type them into the chat box here, the question box, and I'm happy to answer them. We got one here for the ACT suites. Are closure plates provided in between the two rooms? That's a good question. Let me jump back to a ACT suite. We'll use this one. So the question is, you know, if you take a look at the center of this booth, you'll notice there's that little 4-inch airspace on the front wall there. The question is asking, you know, is that going to be covered up by a plate? Like, do we provide anything to cover that airspace, or is it just going to be wide open? Can you look down and see all the way through? So the answer is we will provide a plate to cover that center part. So in between the two booths, we'll have a plate that will cover that 4-inch gap. That comes as a default. But we do have options to provide closure plates to tie off either side of this booth as well as the ceiling. So we can tie this booth off from the wall to the host wall, from the roof of our booth to the host ceiling. Really just gives it a finished look. It makes it look like it's part of the actual building structure, not just kind of placed in there. Those closure plates aren't provided as a default, but again, that center one will be. It's a good question. I like that. I should probably add that into my slides here. We got one more in here. What size pass-throughs are available? So pass-through sleeves, another good question that I should probably add into my presentation. So pass-through sleeves, IAC has three standard sizes for the pass-through sleeves. We have 2-inch, 3-inch, and 4-inch. That is interior diameter. I have done projects that include a 6-inch pass-through. So we do have the capabilities to customize those if you'd like. But the standard, again, is 2-inch, 3-inch, and 4-inch. So there's no more questions in the box. If you think of any after this presentation is over, take down my email or my cell phone and reach out to me whenever you please, and I'm happy to answer the questions. So I want to thank everyone for attending the IAC Acoustics Acutone 2 Medical and Life Sciences webinar. I know your time is valuable, and I do appreciate you spending some of it with me here today. If you'd like a copy of this presentation or would like to discuss a product, please feel free to contact me at your convenience. Please also visit the IAC Acoustics YouTube channel for informational Did You Know videos about all of our products. Thank you again, and I hope you all stay safe and healthy.